pala ako. Dito na nga ang makakasama natin, na una natin makakasama for today. Pero alam ko, kilala nyo siya at nakasama na natin siya minsan dito sa Letters and Music, and now she's back. Born in Canada pero may pusong Pilipino para sa musika. She's back here on Letters and Music to share with us some good music. So let's all welcome back Annie Lux! Hi, Annie!
Hey, how are you?
Welcome back. It's been a long time. Parang 2 years ago yata yung last visit mo.
Opa.
Parang mga ganun, no?
Baby-baby pa ako.
Oo, baby-baby pa. Pero ngayon mukha pa rin baby. So what's your secret?
Wala, ano, tubig.
Ay, ganun!
Water.
Tubig forever. Gagawin ko nga yan. Water Opa. Therapy. So ito, since you're back at simula pa lang ng 2020, how's 2020 treating you so far?
Ganda talaga, maraming blessings, mm-hmm. kahit there's lots happening sa world, like
correct.
The Taal volcano, the coronavirus,
yes.
pero
the bushfire.
So, bushfires sa Australia, pero masyadong blessed ako at masyadong grateful, like I'm so grateful mm-hmm. for all the blessings God has been giving me so far.
Yes, and career-wise, eto din, merong ibabahagi sa atin si Annie na bagong song. Pero eto ah, you've written and recorded songs. Ano yung masasabi mong bago sa music mo? Kasi parang hindi lang sa music eh, no? Pati yung look. Kung i-compare natin, papanoorin natin yung last guesting mo here on Letters and Music, medyo iba talaga.
Apa.
So, kwento mo nung kami, what's with the change of look, change in style din ba ng music? Ano bang mga changes na ito?
I guess I'm more Pinay.
Mm-hmm. More Pinay.
I'm more Filipina na. Mm. Pero in the way that, similar to Catriona Gray, she's Aha. very proud Correct. To be Filipina, Bicolana. So I guess that's the change mm-hmm. in my music and in my sound and my dress, is that I try as much as possible to show pride in my culture na.
Yeah, nice naman. So pagdating sa music naman, ito kanina pinag-uusapan namin during the break, na itong ipaparinig niya sa ating song is parang ito yung first Tagalog
Apa.
Song ni Annie, right?
Apa.
So did you write the song as well?
Opo. So nag-produce ko.
Nag-produce,
yeah,
okay.
I produced it and then composed it, arranged it, and then it was in English mm-hmm. Originally, of course. Mm-hmm. Kasi English era, Americana ko po.
I feel you.
Americana ko po,
are.
Pero joke lang. No, I'm Canadian.
Did you translate it yourself or
no,
you had
I
someone
had,
translate
yeah,
it
I had
for
this
you?
Amazing guy, Jack Buenafe, mm-hmm. and he took all of the themes, so I explained to him, this is why I wrote this song, Heartbroken Ako, but it's about happy endings, about mm-hmm. All of that, it's about being okay kahit it's over. And he's like, oh, I can take your theme. So, ganun. It's just like a concept.
Okay, mm-hmm. that's your concept. So, ito ba based from your personal experience?
Of
Were
course.
You heartbroken that time nang sinulat mo to and you were trying to move on?
Of course. honesty is the best policy. Okay. Am I right?
Tsaka yun din ang mas maganda kapag ka ikaw ay isang singer-songwriter. Eh. Kumbaga, you're able to pour your heart out at mas lalong nakikilala ng mga listeners kung sino ka as a person, kung ano yung mga experiences mo in life. Okay. Diba? So, ito, updated version naman ng style mo when it comes to songwriting.
Yes, mas honest na ako mm-hmm. sa songwriting. Yeah.
And most of it ba or all of it ba personal experience
all
lang?
All of it lahat. Walang always na. So, ngayon always.
Grabe naman ito. So ano sa mga nasulat mong song yung magiging theme song? Yung theme song mo ngayon. Yes. Nasa heartbroken state ka pa rin ba? Or mas happy na?
Both.
Both.
Kasi yung verse, it's heartbroken, pero the chorus, it's tahan na, dadaan lang yan. Like, it's gonna be okay.
Yan. So, it's gonna be okay.
Telling myself I'm going to be okay. Parang it was a song of healing for myself.
Correct. Mm-mm. Parang kinukomfort mo na rin yung sarili mo. Mm-mm. Parang binibigyan mo ng something to look forward to, no? Na mas positive. So, pero ito, pag-usapan naman natin, ah, in the future or maybe this year, meron ba tayong aabangan ng mga collab with other artists? And kung wala pa, may list ba si Annie ng mga artist na gusto mong makakollab since you'll be staying here in the Philippines for good, right? At ito mo na ipapursue ang iyong singing career, which is dapat lang, diba? Dapat lang na mapakinabangan ka namin at marinig namin lagi dito ang music mo. So, sino-sino ba itong listahan mo ng mga makakakollab na artists?
Wala pa. Mm-hmm. Pero gustong-gustong talaga. Tama.
Yeah, yes, gusto.
Inigo Pascual.
Inigo Pascual.
I like his vision. Mm-hmm. And of course, super talented. Maris. If I'm gonna mention Inigo, I have to mention her also. Maris.
Kompleto ang Marnigo, ha? Mm-hmm. Okay.
I would love to collab with Moira or Kiko Nazario.
Wow.
Yeah, the songwriter types.
Yeah. Aabangan namin yan.
Yeah. Sana.
Din. At saka sana din, i-share mo sa amin yan dito sa Letters in Music. Diba?
Yes pa.
So dahil saan, parang I think it's about time we listen to your song. At mapakinggan na at mapanood ng live na live ng ating mga viewers ang first ever Tagalog single.